Epilepsy is a known disorder which is known since 3000 years. It is not a new disorder. Epilepsy is around about all over world we see the patients about the epilepsy, and around about more than 6 million people are affected due to the epilepsy. In India, almost around about 1 to 2 million people are suffering from the epilepsy. Epilepsy is classified as a disorder of the brain in which the brain cells gets overactivated and which produces a state of altered sensorium and with associated with the tonic and clonic posturing or changes into the mood. It is classified into the majorly two types, generalized epilepsy and partial epilepsy. Then it has sometimes it is associated with it is commonly seen in the all the age groups, including childhood to the elderly, and also seen in the women's, equal to male and female ratio is equal. And the commonest causes are like bleeding into the brain, unusual vessels in the brain, brain ischemias, head injuries, unequal brain developmental malformations, metabolic disturbance. These are the most commonest causes of the epilepsy. All fever. What are the precipitants of the epilepsy are stoppage of the drug, sleep deprivation, then high altitude, head injury. These are the precipitants of the or stressor. Then it is broadly classified as a generalized epilepsy, partial epilepsy, and localized and related epilepsy. Broadly, it is classified as a symptomatic epilepsy, remote symptomatic epilepsy, then localized and related epilepsy. Okay. Then, what are the investigations in the epilepsy? Like blood investigation in the form of CBC, blood sugar, to see whether hypoglycemia can also precipitate like epilepsy, then liver function test and ECG. And what are the major clinical features? The major clinical features are like headache, fall, light headedness, tingling numbness in the body, and they may have a tonic-clonic posturings, tongue bite. These are the commonest clinical features. Then post-ictally, patients can have confusion, irritability, somnolence. This can persist up to 24 hours or 12 hours. Then investigations in the epilepsy like CT scan or the MRI. In that MRI will be more beneficial than the CT scan. And MRI will in that MRI flare and T2 sequences and MRI with epilepsy protocol including temporal lobes. Then EEG is the one technique in which we put the electrodes on the brain and we do the recording which shows generalized discharges or the localized discharges. Then in treatment, there are a lot many drugs available nowadays. There are newer drugs are also available. Previously, the commonest drugs are phenytoin, phenobarbital. Nowadays, the newer drugs are like valproic acid, then topiramate and levetiracetam. The most safest nowadays, the drug is the levetiracetam. Then in pregnancy also, the levetiracetam is most safest and also in childhood patients. The treatment depends upon the whether it is generalized seizure or the partial seizure. For partial seizures, the preferred drugs are like valproic acid or the oxcarbazepine. And for generalized seizures, the commonest drugs are phenytoin, levetiracetam, carbamazepine. These are the commonest drugs. Then the add-on drugs are like topiramate, lacosamide, lamotrigine. These are the add-on drugs. The side effects are like associated with all the anticonvulsant drugs, but we need to monitor the side effects and we need to prescribe and modulate the drugs in the patients according to their age, body weight and the state of patients. Whether if lady is there, then whether she is pregnant. In pregnancy, most of it, as I spoke, it is a levetiracetam is the most safest drug. then how long that drug should be continued. The drug, at least minimum, the drug should be continued for 3 to 5 years. Then we need to record the EEG, do we need to do the MRI, and then we need to decide about the continuation of the drug. Then what are the commonest issues like epilepsy? In epilepsy, we need to take the drugs. Marriage cannot, if we do the marriage, some people have a like after marriage epilepsy will go. It is nothing like that. After marriage also we need to take the drugs. Then if a lady is taking the anti-epileptic, we can monitor the drug level, and according to that we can modulate the anti-epileptic drugs. Then other issues are like we need to avoid some form of food like caffeine or coffee. We need to avoid, we need to take proper sleep, we need to avoid the stress. These are the precipitants. And prognosis in epilepsy is very good. If if a patient takes the continuous drug, then the prognosis is very good. They can be free of the epilepsy. Follow-ups, in the form of we need to take follow-ups every monthly in the initial period, then after every 6 monthly we need to have a follow-ups in the form of EEG or the MRI whenever it is needed. Consultation with the doctor or the neurologist is very necessary. These are the major issues with the epilepsy. Epilepsy patient, they should avoid the driving in the night, proper sleep. They should not go at the high altitude, high hill levels, or the swimming should be avoided. Pregnancy is not the contraindicated. Marriage is not the contraindicated. These are the issues.
Epilepsy, at the time of epilepsy, what the patient should or the relatives should take care of that?
The first aid for the epilepsies are, the patient should be lied down, then he should be, a pulse should be checked, whether he is conscious or non-conscious, it should be checked. The patient should be checked for the respiration, and according to that he should be he should be checked whether he has a major trauma or anything like that. And he should be shifted for the immediate ICU or the immediate hospital. These are the major things, first aid for the epilepsy. Nothing, we need to make him relax, lie down. We need to check pulse, as I spoke, pulse and BP. These are the things, and sugar. These are the things.
And major question what patients ask.
It is fully treated condition. It is nothing like it. Ayurvedic drugs are not useful. Homeopathic drugs are not useful. It is only allopathic drugs. And in few patients, in which we get imaging, like temporal lobe epilepsy, in that patient we need to do the surgery for the temporal lobes. If any structural lesion is there, we can remove that structural lesion if the patient has a refractory epilepsy. Otherwise, we can continue the anti-epileptics. Onion or iron, touching of onion or iron is not the treatment for the epilepsy. That will not help for the epilepsy. The treatment with the anti-epileptic drugs in the form of valproic acid, levetiracetam, phenytoin, these are the drugs, the treatment for the epilepsy, not the onion or the iron.